Hello again, this is Thomas from Hotkey404, and as we have mentioned in our previous video, this is the second one in our mini-series about Asterisk mobile channel. So today, I will show you how to create a custom extension and receive a phone call using your headset. So let's jump right into it. Okay, so this is a super easy setup, so I thought maybe we'll do this a bit different. But I'm just curious, and let me know in the comment section what you think about such form of recording the video. So we will quickly log into our Raspberry. Probably you'll hear me typing on my keyboard. So let's start by checking if our Bluetooth is running. So service status, perfect. Service is running. You should expect that. So we will create this config file that we will fill in a second. So we will continue to etc asterisk. And here we can see we have a list of files, but we don't have our chan underscore mobile.conf file. So we will create it with touch and our file. And since all of those are owned by Asterisk, we will do chown. And then Asterisk and our file. Nice. Next, we will need some details that we will need to fill in about the adapter and our headset. So we will use this HCI tool. And dev will show the MAC address of our built-in Bluetooth adapter in our Raspberry. And also we need MAC address of our headset. And to do that, I will just switch this headset into pairing mode. So turn it on, power on, talk time, 6 hours. So I think that will be enough. And once we will do that, no phone connected, pairing. And now HCI tool and scan. And this in a second will show the MAC address and the name of our headset. So let's just wait 2 seconds. We should have some music in the background. Perfect. So we have MAC address and now we can edit our file. So you will use nano, and here we will need 3 sections. First, general, and here we will have interval equals 30, number of seconds between reconnecting to the devices. Then our adapter, and adapter we will have ID, which is a unique name. You can use this HCI0 or anything you want, just the same as in our previous video about connecting our phones. So I will just use HCI0 and address, which will be this one from HCI tool dev, so MAC address of this device. And then we will set up headset. So headset 0, and this is type headset, so a bit different in connecting phones. Then adapter, and this adapter HCI0, so the same name that we have used in adapter section. Then address, and we will copy the MAC address from this command. Perfect. And port. We don't know the port yet, so I will just press 1. Then entering our asterisk, we will do module load and the name of our module. Perfect. It loaded the module, so we can do mobile search. And as you can see, it already tries to connect to my headset. So I can see someone trying to connect. Once again, mobile search to search for the headset, and it will provide us with a port that will be necessary to successfully pair those two devices. So 3, 2, one. Ah, timed it perfectly. So we have port 2. So once again, we can go back here. Port 2. Nice. So once we have that, to reload this whole configuration, I will just do core. Let's restart now. It got disconnected. And it already tells me that pairing is successful. So if we go back here and we will do mobile show devices, you can see that we have our headset 0 and it is connected. So time for part 2. And part 2 is configuration of our FreePBX. So to do that, we will just log in to our console, this web panel. And after a nice welcome message, we will go to Applications, Extensions, and we have already registered this 100 extension for testing purposes, and we will add new custom extension. So we will place, let's say, 200 display name. I will use headset and voicemail and pin sets. Not necessary, but in the third tab, advanced, we need this dial string. To dial this device, we will do mobile and the name of our headset. So since we named it headset 0, this will be the name of our extension. So then we will just press submit. Nice. Apply config. And since this is Raspberry, it is not done instantly. But it will be done in just a few seconds. We have remote Unix connection. And after a second, it will load. So I will just prepare my 100 extension. Perfect. You have it here. And now we can call our 200 extension. So this should go to our headset. So if we do 200, perfect, and dial. Yeah, it is calling. I can hear beeping on my headset. So if I just answer. Oh, not this one. Ta-da! And voila, I can hear myself twice because there is a very annoying echo. But as you can see, mute on. Yeah, it should be muted. But it is really simple. So I've disconnected, and basically this is all you need to connect your headset. As you can see, the configuration is pretty straightforward, so probably you won't make any mistakes. So I hope you enjoyed the video. I'm really interested in your opinion about such form of presenting the configuration. So have an amazing day and see you in the next one.